Dragoonity Knight Escalon. Yeah, I totally didn't see this one coming. A new Dragoonity card, yeah. Better talk about it, since Dragoonity was where it all started for me. It was the original Wombo combo deck back in the days. But yeah. Cybernetic Horizon. So this set is probably coming out after the WCQ season for us. So this is a main set. Dual terminal story-wise, I have no idea why this card exists. Dragoonity story in Season 1. They came and helped the Mist Valley. Never heard about them ever again. Until Dragoonity Divine Lance was introduced in Season 3. But that had nothing to do with Dragoonities. People just like passed that around and shared it amongst the Season 3 archetypes. But yeah, this card, not sure where it fits in. We could be like time traveling back to the past and filling in some gaps of the Season 1 story. Or this could actually be in the present time, which it probably is, since this monster looks like the monster embodiment of Dragoonity Divine Lance. There's a lot of resemblance. The head is Partisan's head. The wings, we have 8 wings in total, which is the same number on Dragoonity Divine Lance. It's golden, which is not very like Dragoonity Divine Lance. You know, its wings look kind of like Mistleton, but I don't think it has anything to do with Mistleton. The Dragoonity armor has like the feathery wings as well. We also have a knight riding on top of it, which looks like ducks to me, which is really weird because we kind of assume ducks is dead at this point. You know, there's been a lot of time between Season 1 and Season 3. You know, look at Kamui, who aged into Ritual Beast Elder. For example, like, that's a lot of time. Also, the Wind factions, Mist Valley and Dragoonities, were not doing well in Season 1, the last we heard of them. Yeah, maybe this means we're gonna get a new Dux clone, which would be really nice, since the normal summoning to start off your combos, and if that gets stopped, you just, like, end turn. So I'm hoping that we get more cards for Dragoonities. Yeah, maybe this is, like, a alternate storyline or something. Like, if they're rebooting up the Season 1 dual terminal archetypes, then we most likely will see multiple support cards of each of the old dual terminal archetypes, which I'm pretty excited for. There's also that weird stuff with Zephyr Metatron, so this could be like a crossover between two worlds, which gave life to Divine Lance. Maybe, you know, there's something going on there. We won't know until the next Master Guide comes out. There's also a really cool sunset of Dragon's Ravine in the background, which adds to the art pretty nicely. But enough of that, let's get on to the card itself. Wind Dragon, as you'd expect from a Dragoonity Knight. Synchro. It's level 10, 3,300 attack, 3,200 defense. It doesn't have the usual Dragon Tuner, Wing Beast non-tuner. This is actually just Dragoonity Tuner and any non-tuners, which makes it much more generic. Just think, you know, its stats, 3-3 attack, 3-2 defense. It's pretty average for level 10s. That's what you expect for level 10s. The effect, there's not much to talk about since this is not a combo piece. It's like an aggressive piece, so it doesn't have that much it could do. It's just, you know, summon it, kill things and attack, hopefully for game. It's that sort of card. So yeah, two effects. The first effect, you can banish one Dragoonity monster from your graveyard, then target one monster your opponent controls, banish that monster. First of all, this is not once per turn, so you can most likely clear all of their monsters. You're probably going to have at least two or three Dragoonities in your graveyard after you've made this thing. So yeah, you can clear all their monsters. It doesn't hit back row, which is really annoying. It's not a quick effect either, which is also pretty annoying. Like, this is 2018. A card kind of needs these aspects to be considered like a good card, especially a good boss monster. Its second effect is a protection effect. So if this synchro summon monster in its owner's control is destroyed by an opponent's card effect or battle, you can special summon one Dragoonity synchro with 3000 or less attack from your extra deck. This is treated as a synchro summon. So yeah, this is a hard one per turn, so you can't, and it's got a lot of restrictions on it, which is annoying. Has to be under your control, has to be killed by an opponent's card. It can't summon itself, throw back to the Stardust Warrior thing. So yeah, this is like pretty similar to Stardust Warrior in that aspect. What it can summon is, though, is Dragoonity Knight Bartra. Or any of the Dragoonity Knights, they're all pretty good. But Bartra is probably the most interesting to summon with this. It essentially makes this card ogre-proof, So if you summon this, your opponent's like, oh shit, he's gonna banish my whole field. You banish one monster and they over it. You can summon Barksha, equip, the same phalanx that you used to make this with. Summon the phalanx and make this guy again, and then proceed to banish the rest of their field. Now, that's pretty cool. Ogre proof. If this is destroyed on your opponent's turn, none of the five other Dragoonity Knights that you can summon off this really does anything like this. You just summon, like, the best thing you can summon is a Gabolg, which is gonna be a 3/5 beat stick, that's all. So, if if they Dark Hole this, they're not really gonna be facing anything worthy of caring about. So, it's a really bad protection effect for a boss monster. The cool thing is, this guy's pretty big. So, after clearing all of your opponent's monsters, hopefully they don't have any crazy back row that's gonna screw us up. This guy's gonna put a lot of damage on board. Say if you have like a Red Eyes Darkness Metal, a Dragoonity Armor Laviton, and a Dragoonity Phalanx in your graveyard, and you look like top deck a Monster Reborn. You hit Monster Reborn the Red Eyes. Red Eyes bring back the Laviton. Laviton brings back the Phalanx. Synchro into this guy. You have at least two Dragoonities in your graveyard at this point, so you can banish two of their monsters. Hopefully that's everything. Attack for 3/3, attack for 2/8, and then main phase 2 overlay for Gust of Max. That's 8,100 damage. That's a pretty cool use for it. This card might just replace Trident Dragaeon for OTK purposes, since it, clears like two of their monsters instead of blowing up two of your own cards. It makes me wonder if Dragoonities are getting more cards in the set. I would like to see a good Dragoonity Synchro monster that can be summoned by this guy from your extra deck that does something on your opponent's turn. Maybe like a Synchro Tuner or something. Although, I'm not sure we need more Synchro Tuners with Needle Fiber around the corner. It would be nice. But yeah, this really gives the impression that there's gonna be more support for Dragoonities in the set. It's kind of like how we had Nine Pillars of the Yangtze announced, and I was like, okay, cool card, doesn't really do much more than Zephyr Divine Strike, that. And then Thinglong was announced, which made that card infinitely better. So I hope we're looking at one of those scenarios, but until then, there's really not that much more I can talk about this card.